With the Anet E10 I got another 3D printer from my sponsor Gearbest. The design is similar to that of the Creality CR10 I've tested in a previous video, however the dimensions of the Anet E10 are clearly smaller. Nonetheless, the print volume of 22x27x30cm is anything but small. Why there is a hole in the backside of the electronics box will be explained later in this video. The printer comes almost pre-assembled. As with many cheap printers, there are minor scratches on the surface of some components, however that doesn't affect the functionality. The good build instruction is available in a printed version as well as PDF and a video on the microSD card. I needed approximately 2 hours to assemble the printer, however I took many pictures and video sequences during my build, and I had to eliminate minor errors in design. The aluminum frame is very solid. The X-axis is guided along one of the aluminum profiles by plastic rolls. Quality and shape of the rolls are anything but perfect, you can feel that the movement is a bit rough while operating the printhead manually. At the endpoints of the X-axis you can see that the lower edge of the belt doesn't run in parallel to the movement of the printhead, an issue you can observe at many cheap printers. The Y-axis moves along round steel bars guided by metal bearings. The movement of that axis is clearly smoother. There is also an issue with the belt that doesn't run in parallel to the movement of the axis out of the box, however that error is easy to fix. The electronics is in a solid metal box. The LCD screen is a bit loose in its frame which doesn't really matter when operating the printer. But the rotary button has to be pulled out every now and then to make it trigger properly. Wiring is done quickly, all plugs are protected against reverse polarity and labeled perfectly. As written in the build instruction, use the correct terminals to wire up the end switches. I cut off approximately half of the polytetrafluoroethylene tube running to the hot end, it shouldn't be longer than needed to reduce friction. There is an issue with the wiring of the set motors. The build plate hits the plugs while moving along the Y-axis. So I turned the motors for 90 degrees to make it all work properly, however a couple of screws had to be loosened to do so. Let's turn the printer on for the first time. Through the printer menu, nozzle and build plate get preheated for PLA with the print bed being set to 50 degrees Celsius. After approximately 3 minutes, the target temperature is reached and with that you can put the plastic sheet on the build plate. Make sure that no bubbles are underneath the foil. Next step is adjusting the printer. Whenever the motors are disabled, you can turn the spindles of the Z-axis freely by what the frame of the machine bends and the X-axis gets misaligned. First thing to be done is moving both ends to the same height, for what I am using a pen as reference. The spindles are turned manually until the pen fits under both ends of the X-axis. Leveling the print bed starts with turning all corner points of the build plate to a low position. Auto home all axes afterwards, especially the Z axis must move to the end switch. With the motors being disabled, you can move the printhead to the corner positions manually and raise the blade by turning the knurled nuts. Adjust a gap of 1 to 2 mm in the first run. And reduce that gap step by step until nothing but a sheet of paper fits tightly between nozzle and print bed in the final run. Now you can insert filament. The printer comes with 2 10-meter rolls of white PLA. As soon as the target temperature of 200 degrees Celsius is reached, you can push the lever at the extruder motor and insert the filament, which is always a bit fiddly at this printer. As you can see, no plastics exits the nozzle. I found the reason for that after removing the Bowden on top of the hot end. There was a piece of plastics jamming on top of the drill hole. The worker in the factory did obviously not remove the filament properly after a test run. While working with the E10, I found that the filament is always jamming at that point when trying to remove a spool. The inner diameter of the Teflon tube is larger than that of the 2 mm drill hole on top of the hot end, thus it can't work properly. To fix that issue, you should replace the Teflon tube with one having the correct inner diameter. I widened the drill hole to 2.5 mm, which is not the best solution. After inserting the micro SD card and initializing the storage device, you can select a file and so start a print job. I am using a file named Chess that came with the printer. The job starts after the target temperatures of print bed and hot end are reached. The first layers were printed as expected, so I went back to my office to continue working on other stuff. When I came back after 10 minutes, I saw that the job was aborted. Temperature of print bed and hot end were set to zero, which was why I thought that a short power failure caused the error. However, when I tried to start that file again, the voltage dropped, causing the printer to reboot. So there was an internal reason for the power failure, I figured out that the power supply was faulty. I replaced the device by the 12 volts line of an old computer power supply I had in stock. And that worked. After telling the manufacturer about the faulty power supply, he sent a spare part to Germany. More about that on my pages. The mantra of my projects is to fix issues in a simple way and that's what I did by using the old computer power supply. So let's continue with testing the printer. In the second run, the job was finished after approximately 1 hour and the result isn't bad. Another issue with the printer came to my mind when starting own projects. Even while the nozzle temperature was set to 210 degrees Celsius, during operation the real temperature was no more than 195 degrees. The fan of the printhead that normally cools the upper part of the extruder is also blowing on the lower part that is called hot end for good reasons. A piece of captain tape at the lower part of that fan keeps the airflow away from the nozzle and with that the printhead reaches 210 degrees with ease. I hate wasting my time with printing sculptures or benchmark figures, which is why I designed a special gimbal mount as a test run. It's composed of a variety of gears, the largest with a diameter of 19.9cm going to the edges of the print bed. Rapid changes in direction are needed to print the teeth of the gears. The tooth width of this middle-sized gear is only 2mm. More about my printer test and the mechanics built from all the parts is shown in a subsequent video. You can see that there are gaps on top of the gears. That's because of the too weak extruder motor. The motor is skipping by what the filament doesn't move with the accordant amount and so the flow of plastics exiting the nozzle is too low. Here I am printing with 60mm per second with a layer height of 0.2mm. Maybe with a better Teflon tube having the correct inner diameter, the friction is lower and the printer works with higher speeds. With the current setup, the print speed has to be lower to get good results. With a reduced print speed of no more than 30mm per second, I got clearly better results. To get an impression of the print quality, you can have a look at high resolution photos of the prints I made with the E10 on my pages. All in all, the gears and threads work, so that this printer is at least an applicable device after eliminating the errors in design. There are obviously quality issues, so that the manufacturer must do his homework before I would call this printer a good deal for non-experts. While experts can handle all the trouble with ease, for beginners in 3D printing, this might be a frustrating experience. I really like the look of the relatively sturdy aluminum frame, but I dislike the plastics wheels, even if they are obviously doing their job. Those wheels are another point in design I'd like to be changed by the manufacturer. You can read all about the ANET E10 and more 3D printers on my project pages. Thanks for watching and I'll be back.